we gonna play now, ready for the show. I'm about to take down, you already know. Get the fuck out of my face now, yeah, you gotta go. Man, I'm on the chase now.
Hey, 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 today is the day, the big reveal. Hey, so, I'm slick mad at y'all, because I was looking at the other two videos, and nobody told me that I look like I don't have a neck. I have a whole thick-ass neck. Y'all just sat there, and y'all let me look frumpy in front of everybody. It's pretty fucked up. Don't appreciate it, but it's all right. We're gonna get past this. So today, we finally get to see the hero. We get to see Casanova himself. We will be introducing Adrian. This is gonna be good. I hope y'all enjoyed it. It took me a long time to write this shit. Like, well, you can't see it now because apparently the computer didn't wire it right, but it's cool. So y'all gonna see his backstory. And then we're going to get caught up to where we are today. It's going to be good. All right. See y'all after.
I wish I could tell y'all that Adrian was some type of Prince Charming. I'm going to tell y'all this man turned out to hit the lottery and has open money. At the very least, I wish I could tell you he has all his shit together. That he is where he wants to be in life. Sadly, none of that is true. There's nothing special about him. He is as basic as it comes. He works a regular job. He makes a lot less than Jesse and Benji. He has a regular, normal car. Sorry to brush y'all up. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying Adrian is broke or a moocher by any means. He makes his own money. He pays his own bills and he doesn't take handouts. He's educated. Although, he doesn't work in his field. What I'm getting at is he's still in the immature phase. He isn't thinking about long term. He's only thinking about today. I mean, is that so wrong though? A good looking young black man, still in his 20s, living his best life. He's single, he has no kids. He only has one person to worry about, and that's himself. Now what he is, he's a free spirit. He doesn't live his life just to work and pay bills. He takes his money and he goes live life. He believes any time can be a good time. The last thing he thinks about is beef and drama. And they certainly don't linger in his mind. And more importantly, the man is a lover. A lover of life and an even greater lover of his women. And he has a good heart. Just looking to settle down with somebody's daughter. But being in love with a good heart isn't going to bring stability or financial peace of mind. Quite the contrary. What it does bring is a lot of heartbreaks and a lot of disappointments. I think the kids call it being a simp. He didn't always used to be that way. Nah. Casanova used to be the biggest hoe you'd ever know. Having anybody he wanted whenever he wanted. And knocking hoes down left and right. The world was his oyster. And he was cracking that bitch open. One loose lady at a time. Then he met a girl. No, not Chelsea. This is way before that. Beautiful girl. A little on the hood side, but she was so sweet and full of life. She was the first one he ever told I love you to. He was genuinely happy. Never felt this feeling before. That girl would have done anything for him. They were a perfect match. Soul mix, if you will. He cut everybody off for her. He knew she was his one. He ain't fucking that up for nobody. Except he did. Adrian's best friend asked him to be his wingman. He was really into this girl, but she had this clingy, cop-blocking ass friend who was always the third with him. He just wanted some alone time with her. But the girl mentioned she liked Adrial. And she thought he was cute. Of course, Adrial refused. He got a girlfriend. Ain't no way in hell he getting caught up in somebody else's shit. His homeboy assured him he didn't have to do anything with the girl. All he wanted him to do, just sit in the living room with her and just talk to her. You ain't gotta be nasty. You don't have to do anything. Just sit down and talk to her. That's it. And that's exactly what Adrian did. He sat on the opposite couch of her. And he talked to her. He conversed. It was really friendly. Nothing extreme. They were just chilling. He even told her that he had a girlfriend. Matter of fact, the whole time he was texting his girlfriend. The girl was cool and understanding. An hour later, the other two came out. And they went home. I don't even think he really called her name. It started with a D. Sound like it was a biblical or something. But that's it. No scandals. Or so he thought. Christmas morning, Adrian's girlfriend called him. Wanted to meet up. He thought nothing of it. He had to give her a present anyway. So he pulled up to her house. When she opened the door, she was crying. And before he could ask what's wrong, she rocked his shit. She punched him dead in the face. Then she asked him, who is Delilah? Dazed and confused, he repeated it. Who is Delilah? She hit him again. This time in the eye. Heartbroken. Tears flowing from her face, man. She tells him these girls came to her job and told her how her boyfriend was going to leave her for one of them. And then how he told her where the girl works. Even went as far as to say all the nasty things that he was going to do to her. When she started explaining what the girl looked like, it clicked in his head that this was the chick that he was sitting in the living room with, just having a conversation. Here he is trying to explain the situation with his best friend, and that he doesn't even know this girl. And at this point, he starts tearing up because he can hear himself explaining this to him, and it doesn't even sound believable to him. And he knows he's about to lose it, but it's the truth, and that's what hurts the most. You tell him the truth, and it sounds like a lie. It was like he was having an out-of-body experience. He can see himself explaining it, but he can't hear the words anymore. All he can see is her breaking down and crying. She trusted him. She wanted to be with him forever, man. He couldn't hear himself. But he heard all the pain in her voice. You could hear how bad he hurt her. She started hitting him again. Repeatedly. Just punch him in the face. At this point, he's not even trying to block it. He know he deserves it. She drops down on her knees and she's crying. He betrayed her. Just standing there. Face bruised and bloody. Crying. He never thought in a million years he would have been the one to hurt her. Not this bad. Not this bad. She kicked him out. Broke up with him. He called and called, but never got an answer. It was over. He lost his soulmate. That bitch Delilah, man. Somehow she got his number. She tried to call him. He told her if she ever contacted him again, he'll break her fucking face. And then he'll get a restraining order on him. He never heard from his love again. 4 years later, he did see her in the womb. She had a 2-year-old baby with her. She was also with her fiance. That's about it. He told himself if he ever found someone to love again, he would never put her through the same thing. But unfortunately, relationship after relationship, none of them worked out. Never could find anybody to match that same level of love. Till about a couple years later, and he met Jesse. Adrian was cool with dating for a while. He was down with it. Especially after his last ex. He was just gonna chill. Ain't nobody thinking about women right now. So it was one day he was scrolling on Facebook. Scrolling, minding his business, being nosy. He came across, and the people you may know, this very nerdy looking girl. Her name is Chelsea. I don't know why she caught his eye. She was very bland looking. Her page was bland. She just looked like a normal, normal. Nothing special about her. I mean, she did have the most gorgeous smile you ever seen in his life. Absolutely beautiful. Maybe that was it. I guess that was enough. Because he added her. He never inboxed her, though. He was just chilling. She just sat there for months. They were just Facebook friends at this point. But one day, Chelsea was talking basketball. And she mentioned her favorite player, who was his favorite player. And he just thought that was the most adorable thing ever. That was cute. So he decided, I'm gonna talk to her. So he inboxed her. And she left him on red. Straight curve, my man. She did eventually come around, though. And they were talking, and they talked all night till the sun came up. They actually talked for the next 3 days while they were at work, after work, all day, just talking. They were amazed how much they had in common. They were talking about their exes. They had similar stories with what was going on. They would talk about, their futures. ambitions, their goals. And it was really amazing. You know what? I'm going to spare you guys the details. We know they got together. So 2 months later, after they met, they made it official. Well, he asked her to be his girlfriend, and she declined. She said she don't think it's a good idea for them to date. Actually, she think they should just cut it off right now. She's in a bad situation. It was with her ex, and she wanted to stop it before, you know, anything got rolling. Which is fair. I mean, it's tough news. But it's better to end things before they get started. I mean, it was hard, of course, because it still hit her up, you know, to check on her. Wanted to hang out. Basically doing what they were doing, just not with the title of, you know, a couple. A week after, though, it was so random. She asked him, did he still want her to be his girlfriend? Of course he did. He made it official right then, no hesitation. He handled that. You guys already know how their relationship was. It was solid. It was great. It was love. It was a feeling long forgotten for her. I mean, this was the first time in a long time somebody went all out for him. Especially for his birthday. When he got sick, she came and took care of him. She would go out of her way and buy him stuff, even though she knew he hated it. He caught her one time sneaking clothes into his closet. That girl was special. He remembered everything she ever told him that she never experienced. Or that she never had. And he would go out and do it all one by one. He was surprised that I worked with edible arrangements. Treated her to nice dates. He loved that girl. This was his redo. Never in his wildest dreams did he think this would happen again. She made him want to be a better man. He was finally ready to grow up. Finally. All of a sudden, on a random day, she broke up with him. Yeah. Randomly. There was no argument. There was no Delilah. There was no type of scandal. Just poof. She ended it all. And again, for months, he tried calling. He tried texting. He was begging and pleading. She didn't want him, man. And according to her, she never did. She crushed that man's spirit. explanations. She was gone. Didn't give a fuck how he would turn out or how it may have affected him. Maybe it was another guy. Maybe it was the ex. Who knows? All he knew was he had to move on again. Fast forward to today. He's doing well for himself. He did finally start to try to grow up. He got a new job. He starts on Monday. He's single. He's not dating anyone. He's just living his best life. He's happy. He wants to celebrate getting a new job. So he goes up to his favorite diner up the street. He's sitting down at the dining counter. He's eating his food, chilling, enjoying himself, minding his business. Out of nowhere, he hears a familiar voice. No matter how many years have passed by, he's not gonna forget this voice. He looks over his shoulder, and in the corner booth, he sees Delilah with some dudes in a factory uniform. He can't believe it. Out of all people, it's her. He doesn't want her to see him. He doesn't need this type of negativity. So he just put his money on the counter and he slips out. Furious on the way home. Alright. So Monday comes around. He gets up early for work. He drives to the job. He still can't believe that he's seen Delilah, out of all people. He's thinking about this as he's going to the building, going up to his floor where his new boss is. But then he thinks, you know what? This probably was just some sort of coincidence. You know, he ain't seen him this long. It's probably a good chance. He's never gonna see her again. This is gonna bring him down. This is gonna ruin his day. He takes a deep breath and he goes in with his new boss to meet his new co-workers. As soon as he walks in, he sees Chelsea.
Catch a break. Tisk, tisk, tisk. I was rooting for that. I thought it was gonna be just a simple, hey, I see her, I like her, let's rekindle this. Apparently not. This ain't right. That fucking Delilah is a problem though. I don't understand that chick. Of course I do. I know everything. But I don't know how to go forward. I don't know. Y'all think we should end it right here? Nah. Bring us some more stuff. I've been watching the Have and the Have Nots. It's always a cliffhanger and it's always some drama. And that's what I'm gonna go for. Really feed into that. But I'm also gonna start doing regular videos again. I mean, I haven't been able to carpe diem. Because, you know, pandemic, I've been sitting in the house. It's really hard to go out and get a drink. So I've been, as y'all see, I make my own drinks here. The next video I'm gonna make, I'm probably show y'all how to make another drink. And we're gonna see what else we can do after that. I know y'all don't wanna just read the story, well, hear the stories. But I'm going to still do that, and I'm going to make some differences. Alright? So, you know what it is. Like, share if you care, comment, hit the subscribe button, also hit the notification button so you know when I post. Alright? See y'all next time. Deuces.
Boat, boat. Boat, boat. Yeah. Yeah. Boat, boat.